Decaffeination is a complex and delicate process that aims to preserve the flavour and aroma of the coffee while eliminating or reducing the caffeine content. Here is an overview of some common decaffeination methods. Let's start with the Swiss water method. This method begins with the production of green coffee extract, GCE. In this first phase, a batch of green coffee beans is soaked in hot water. During this soaking time, the caffeine and other soluble components are extracted from the beans. These components include the various flavor and aroma compounds intrinsic to coffee. However, it is important to note that the beans used in this initial stage are essentially sacrificial, as they are not utilized any further. After preparing the GCE, we come to the core of the decaffeination process. A new batch of green coffee beans is introduced and soaked in this GCE. The beauty of this step is the selective extraction process. As the GCE is already saturated with flavor compounds from the first batch of beans, it does not extract these flavors from the new batch. Instead, it selectively removes caffeine. This is similar to the concept of equilibrium in chemistry, where the GCE, already balanced with flavors, only seeks to balance its caffeine levels, drawing out the caffeine from the new batch of beans. The caffeine-laden water, now containing the extracted soluble elements of the coffee beans, is then passed through a series of activated charcoal filters. Activated charcoal has a unique property. It is highly efficient at capturing caffeine molecules while allowing smaller flavor compounds to pass through. The result is a caffeine-free but intensely flavored GCE. The carbon filtration traps the caffeine molecules, leaving the flavor compounds intact. The caffeine is then removed from the carbon through heating, making the carbon reusable for future filtration cycles. Finally, the decaffeinated beans are removed from the GCE, dried, and are ready for roasting. The remarkable thing about the Swiss water process is that the original flavor and aroma profile of the beans is retained, a crucial aspect for coffee drinkers. This process ensures that the decaffeinated coffee retains the depth and richness of flavor that is often lost with other decaffeination methods. The Swiss water process is a more expensive decaffeination method than, say, the methylene chloride process. However, it is considered the most environmentally friendly and least harmful to the flavor of the coffee. Next, we have the direct solvent method. This begins with green coffee beans. These beans have not yet been roasted, preserving their natural state and chemical composition. In a first step, these beans are steamed. Steaming serves a critical function. It opens up the pores of the beans and prepares them for a better interaction with the decaffeinating agent. Once the beans have been sufficiently steamed, they are fed into the solvent. The solvents typically used are methylene chloride or ethyl acetate. These chemicals are chosen for their ability to selectively dissolve caffeine without significantly altering the other compounds that give the coffee its flavor and aroma. The beans are soaked in the solvent for about 10 hours. During this soaking time, the caffeine molecules in the beans dissolve in the solvent. This selective extraction makes the direct solvent method particularly effective. Once the caffeine extraction is complete, the solvent is drained away. But this is not the end of the process. To ensure that no solvent residue remains on the beans, they are steamed again. This additional steaming step is crucial for safety and quality, as it ensures that the end product is free of unwanted chemical residues. Once the decaffeination process is complete, the beans are dried and ready for roasting. At this stage, most of the caffeine has been removed from the beans, but they have retained most of their original flavor profile. While the direct solvent method is very efficient and cost-effective, it is not without its drawbacks. The use of chemical solvents has led to environmental and health concerns. While methylene chloride and ethyl acetate are effective in caffeine extraction, they are volatile organic compounds, VOCs. VOCs can have adverse environmental impacts and potential health risks if handled improperly. To mitigate these concerns, the industry applies strict safety standards. The process usually takes place in a closed system to minimize VOC emissions. In addition, the beans are thoroughly tested after decaffeination to ensure that any residual solvent levels are within the safe and acceptable limits set by food safety authorities. Finally, we have the carbon dioxide, CO2 process. This process involves the use of supercritical CO2, a unique state of matter that combines properties of both gases and liquids, making it an ideal solvent for caffeine extraction. The CO2 process begins with green coffee beans. In an initial step, these beans are soaked in water. This soaking is crucial as it opens the pores of the beans and prepares them for the subsequent decaffeination process. Once the beans are ready, they're placed in a special chamber. Here, carbon dioxide is introduced under high pressure. The key to this process is to bring the CO₂ to a state above its critical point, where it takes on the properties of a supercritical fluid. In this unique state, the CO₂ can penetrate the beans like a gas, and at the same time dissolve and extract substances like a liquid. As the supercritical CO₂ flows through the coffee beans, it dissolves the caffeine molecules. In this phase, the caffeine is extracted from the beans, whilst leaving most of the essential flavour compounds intact. After extraction, the caffeine-laden CO₂ is separated from the coffee beans. The system then depressurizes the CO₂, returning it to its gaseous state and leaving the extracted caffeine behind. This caffeine can be captured and often recycled, adding an element of sustainability to the process. The decaffeinated beans are then dried and sent for roasting. One of the remarkable aspects of the CO₂ process is its ability to retain most of the coffee's original flavor profile, leaving the beans 99% caffeine-free. Now let's look at the advantages of this method. The CO₂ process is free of chemical solvents, making it a popular choice for those who are concerned about chemical residue in their coffee. It's also non-toxic and has minimal impact on the environment, which further increases its appeal. However, it should be noted that this sophistication comes at a price. The CO₂ process is more expensive than other decaffeination methods, a factor that can affect accessibility and use. After decaffeination, the beans are often tested for residual CO₂ to ensure quality, safety, and compliance with industry standards. Now for some tips on how to choose the right decaf coffee that suits your taste and ethical preferences. When choosing decaf coffee, pay attention to the decaffeination method information on the packaging, as this can have a big impact on the flavor and quality of the coffee. Secondly, certifications are important. If you value organic products, or are aware of the ethical aspects of coffee production, look out for certifications such as Organic, Fair Trade, or Rainforest Alliance. Another tip is not to be afraid to experiment with different flavors and varieties. Decaf coffee is available in a wide range of options, from flavored varieties to single origin beans. Each offers a unique taste profile, and by experimenting, you can discover a decaf coffee that really pleases your palate. Reading reviews can also be very helpful. The experiences and opinions of other coffee lovers can help you find a decaf coffee that is well received and likely to be an enjoyable experience. Finally, never underestimate the value of getting advice from your barista. If you frequent coffee shops, ask the barista for their recommendations for decaf coffee. Their expertise and experience can be invaluable when it comes to making an informed decision. The world of decaf coffee is vast and varied, offering a spectrum of choices for those seeking the pleasure of coffee without the caffeine. From different methods of decaffeination that shape the taste and aroma, to various types like organic, fair trade, and flavored options, decaf coffee has something for everyone.